Welcome to Analytics with Nags.
Here we're going to see about how to show the totals along with the axis numbers in charts, typically in bar charts or in matrix report, any kind of charts. What I'm trying to say, for example, this particular bar chart showing value for A, B, C, D, and the total is around $10,000. You need to show another bar saying that $10,000. That is what, as simple as that. How to achieve it in Power BI? Let us see in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts and tips and tricks in Power BI. Let us jump into a demo. Now, a lot of people will ask me like that is very simple way to achieve it, but this is not intended video for this. But there is an option called waterfall chart where you can see like the total value. So whatever the total value, this is our typical Naga Garments dashboard for which we have total amount is 417,000 is the total value, and that is what I'm showing it here. So the enabling tree chart is not the intended output here, required output, because it's like tree chart will it's different concepts, like you need whether it's grown or decreased like that. It will show the values will be decreased or increased over different period or different categories. That is what the tree chart is meant for, I mean to say the waterfall chart is meant for, and you can see the total obviously, but this is not the case. You want to see it in the bar chart like this, right? So how to achieve it? That is some tricky things you need to taken care of while doing this, and I'm trying to explain it now. So what we need to do, typically in a bar chart, if you want this requirement, this should be part of this column. What I'm trying to say, you see what are the columns I've used for this mapping of this bar chart is the category hierarchy that includes item name and a category, and item amount is my measure. So let us see this one. So in this you have item name and item category, whatever you are seeing it here. Oh, what happened? It's filtered. Let us clear all filters. So in this you need to have one total. Okay, there is whatever you are seeing it here is base table. The total appearing should be here, I mean the total entry should be here, and the value corresponding to total, say for example for 6th of February 2020 and on shop, and this should be total. The for 6th of March, everything should be total, right? And it should be tagged for instead of item names, okay, for 6th of month and order type. We need to consider all other parameters except for the members, okay? Ignore these two members and get all other group by values and store that value. What I'm trying to say, so 6th February, and forget about the receipt number, we are not seeing here. On shop, total, that is, you sum up all the values on 6th February. Let us try to filter 6th February so that it will be better. So 6th February, on type order, on shop and online order, total. So you sum up all the values over here and put one entry at the bottom. So when you use this item name or category name in the x-axis, you will get another entry total for all those filter, and even your date dimension will work perfectly all right. So let us try to see how to do that. I want to make an entry. So I will transform this data. Let us try to get the group by of values, ignoring these two columns, and so that I will make entry total for each combination. You cannot just put blank total here, because whatever combination you put group by, for those combinations your filtering will work perfectly all right. You can filter on this particular date on shop, what is my total, on online order on this date, what is my total. So all combination will work perfectly all right. So how to do it? Let us duplicate this data. Then I want to perform group by. So select all the columns. Let us move this particular location towards my left hand side, move towards the beginning. Then based on location, sale date and order type, okay, these three combination I want to put an entry like group by of column. Other things are meshes. So these three combinations, based on your situation, it will be changing. So I want sum of sales amount. So these measures are what aggregations you need to define. So I will keep same item amount here. Then again add aggregation for this as sum of sales quantity. For now, for simplicity, I will go for only two measures. So likewise, you need to define it. Okay, then once you press OK, you will get one temporary table which is having the result for the group of values for Chennai 6th on shop. This is the value on Chennai 6th online order. This is the value. This is your actually the total value, and this item should be added here in the item amount and item quantity, but here in the item name and item category it will be shared as total. So I will create some duplicate dummy column for item name and category name which will hold just like what I'm trying to say is just as a dummy column like total. Okay, item name as total. That's it. So item name will have total. Then again for this category name also you put total. And you have something like receipt. So all other columns will be synced, right? No need to leave that one. So when you need to merge, you're going to merge these two tables now. So receipt, it can be any dummy values. You can put it as 1, 2, 3 something, because it is now nowhere it's not going to use. Okay, but when your calculation involves distinct count of receipt number, those things you need to be careful. Okay, you need to ignore this total entries from the your calculations. That's fine. Now let us try to merge append. I will combine this table and whatever the total table. Okay, append two tables, data two. Just press okay. Now you go and see here, this is absolutely fine, and you can see in item name or item category you will have entry called total. Okay, this is good. Now I no need to get this value there in my power desktop, so just I will enable disable it. There you go. Now you can see here 417 is my total earlier, right? This is appearing here, but if you can see here you can filter this one, I mean without selecting the total. Okay, so you need to be very careful here how you have written the queries, right? You achieved your desired results. Okay, the total of all these things is 4170,000, and you achieved it. So whatever queries you are writing, you need to ignore this particular column, value in your calculations if you are writing it. Okay, so this is just a workaround. We use it in specific cases. I hope you like this video. Hit the thumbs up button below, and if you have any queries, comment below. And do remember that data is your asset.